Airplanes have come a long way since the Wright brothers made their first flight at Kitty Hawk, North Carolina in 1903. But the physics of flight and the forces that keep planes in the air have not changed. The four basic forces that act on every plane in flight are well known to every pilot. They are gravity, lift, drag, and thrust. Additionally, planes and their passengers undergo G-forces during flight. We'll look at each of these forces in detail. Gravity may be the simplest of the forces to understand. Gravity is the pull exerted between all objects with mass. The larger their mass and the closer they are, the more they pull on nearby objects. And since planets like the Earth have tremendous mass, any objects nearby, like airplanes, skydivers, and grandsons, are pulled down toward the planet's surface. While gravity pulls planes down to the ground, the force that works against gravity is lift. Lift opposes gravity and keeps planes in the air. Since air has mass, objects moving through it behave the same as objects moving through any fluid. In the 18th century, Swiss physicist Daniel Bernoulli discovered that as fluids, including air, increased in velocity, their pressures decreased. This relationship between velocity and pressure is the foundation for the shape of airplane wings. If we take the cross-section of a wing, we can see how Bernoulli's principle is applied in aircraft design. This cross-section shape is called an airfoil. If we draw a chord line from the leading edge to the trailing edge of the wing, we can see that there is more wing above the chord line than below. When the plane is moving forward, air hits the leading edge and splits, with some going above the wing and some going below. But the air going above the wing has to travel a longer distance to reach the trailing edge. This gives the air above the wing a higher velocity than the air below the wing, and that velocity difference creates a relative pressure difference. Lower pressure above the wing and higher pressure below. This pressure difference creates an upward movement in the wing, lifting it up along with the attached plane. As long as the amount of lift provided by the wings is greater than the pull of Earth's gravity, the plane will stay in the air. Air is necessary for lift, but air can also slow a plane down. Our third force, drag, is the resistance exerted on any object moving through a fluid. As objects move through fluids, like air, they have to push the fluids aside in order to make room for them. Anyone who has tried to walk in a pool has felt this fluid resistance. This resistance increases with speed, and it also increases with the surface area facing the direction of travel. A parachute has a lot of surface area facing the direction of travel. This is how parachutes are able to use drag to slow a skydiver's fall. But by decreasing the frontal surface area of an airplane, we can decrease drag. And as we decrease drag, we decrease the amount of thrust required to move the plane. And thrust, the force that opposes drag, is next in our list. Thrust is the forward push from a plane's engine. Whether a motor-driven prop or a jet engine, the principle of thrust remains the same. As a propeller spins, it works like a screw, driving itself forward as it pushes air behind it. Jet engines do the same thing using several internal fan blades, pulling air into their front and pushing air out the back at very high speeds. All plane engines are based on Newton's second and third laws of motion. They are designed to push great masses of air opposite the direction of travel. And since there is a single interaction between the engine and the air, the magnitude of force used to push the air backward is the same as the resulting force that pushes the engine forward. This is Newton's third law. As they push this mass of air backward, the engine and attached plane moves forward. The harder the engine pushes, the greater the mass of air it moves, and the faster the acceleration of the plane. This is Newton's second law. Gravity, lift, drag, and thrust are the four basic forces. But there's another force that pilots and passengers have to deal with, G-force. G-force is only a perceived force. Sometimes it's called a false force. But we feel it any time we undergo acceleration. We feel it in cars, elevators, planes, and amusement park rides. Since the masses of our bodies resist change in motion, acceleration in any direction makes us feel like we're being pulled in the opposite direction. When the elevator we're in accelerates upward, we feel as though our bodies get heavier as they're pushed down to the floor. And if we're in an elevator that accelerates downward, We feel lighter than normal as our mass is pushed upward. This push that we feel is a result of Newton's first law, which states that objects with mass resist changes in motion. This doesn't just happen going up and down. This happens when we turn to change directions, too. When we turn a sharp corner with our cars, we feel our bodies being pushed toward the outside of the turn. Just like in cars, this happens in airplanes. But unlike drivers, pilots can bank the planes toward the center of the turn. If they want to turn left, they can dip the left wing as they begin the turn. This balances the g-forces, so combined with the gravity pulling downward, the pilot and passengers feel like they're being pulled straight into their seats, rather than to one side or the other. Pilots use an instrument called a turn coordinator to get just the right bank for each turn. As they turn the plane, they try to keep the marble in the middle of the instrument, ensuring the passengers aren't tossed to one side of the plane. Managing g-forces isn't just about comfort, though. More importantly, pilots must always make sure to never turn so fast that the g-forces become excessive. If g-forces become too great, blood can be pulled away from the brain and unconsciousness will result. If the g-forces are higher still, they can even rip the wings off a plane. Gravity, lift, drag, thrust, and g-forces. Five forces acting on planes. Lift overcomes gravity, thrust overcomes drag, and trained pilots can manage g-forces to make flight as comfortable and safe as possible. And that is how planes fly.